That's the serial number A10457. That section is lower, draws the air and sends it through the header section. And the air goes through the multiple contraction on the screens and goes through the test section, which is made of friction gas, so people can easily see. Inside the wind tunnel, we have the sensor to measure the velocity of the air and also thermocouple right next to that. And the wind tunnel door can be easily opened by holding this handle. They can put it back and then they can put the latches back to lock in place. The blower section has two wires. One is a signal wire, one is the power wire, which are connected to the controller. And also the heater section is connected to another cable. That cable is also connected to the controller. So the wind tunnel works with the controller. It's called CLWTC 1000, and the serial number of this controller is 810256. The front panel of the controller shows the temperature, the existing temperature in the wind tunnel, which is 42 degrees C. At the bottom is the set temperature, which is 20 degrees C. And the back side of the controller has multiple wires, which I can show you what they are. One is the main power, which is coming from 220 on the wall. It's one phase, 220, that means each phase has 115 at the ground. Then we have the cable for the heater, the middle one that goes to the heater on the wind tunnel. Then the third cable is the lower cable, which is going to the blower. That's the power to the blower. And this wire here is a control signal that is going again to the blower. This connector here is attached to our candlestick sensor to measure the velocity, and that's a thermocouple. And here is a cable which goes to the USB on a PC or laptop for communication between the controller and the software. So the system is made of three parts: the wind tunnel, the controller, and the software. The next step, I'll show you the operation of the software. The software, again, is called Sage Control 1000, version 3.2. And it has multiple inputs. First of all, when you connect the instrument to the computer, it has to automatically detect the COM port, which in this case is COM 21. Then you can choose what the unit is for the temperature, either degrees C or degrees Fahrenheit. And also unit for the velocity, meter per second or feet per minute. Then in these two options here, you can set minimum velocity and maximum velocity, and you can also set the temperature of the wind tunnel here by clicking on the number here. And in this location, you basically put the dwell time in minutes. The dwell time means how long you want the wind tunnel to stay in that specific velocity for the duration, dwell time. And number of test points. Let's say if you want to run from 2 meters per second to 5 meters per second at three different points, you have to put the three points, which means 2, 3.5, and 5, 3 points. So as a simple example, I'm gonna set the wind tunnel here. I'm gonna put the 6 meters per second, 5 meters per second, because the maximum velocity in this wind tunnel is about 5. And I also put the end point at 5, just to make it quick. And I put that 85 degrees C, the temperature that we like to do. And I put 60 minutes, that means it's gonna run Once it gets to 85 degrees, then it stays there for 60 minutes until it stops. And just one point. And all you have to do is just run or press the start. And the wind tunnel starts from low speed until it gets to that 5 meters per second. And also the temperature, which the velocity is being shown on the left chart. The temperature is being shown on the right hand side. So you can see that the velocity very quickly ramps up. Right now it's 4 meters per second. And going up for 4.6. And you can see on the right hand side the temperature is ramping up. 40 degrees on the softer, and that number should be exactly the same as what you see in the screen. For example, right now it's 41.6, or 41, it's going up pretty quick, 42, and that's what you have to see there. Yeah, they have to match. Whatever is reporting on the screen, you should see on the computer, on the software. I see the fluctuations here because the scale changed. So you see fluctuations, but they are very small. It's like 0.1 from upper lower side and upper side. 0.1 meter per second. And you can clearly see that the temperatures are very smoothly. Guess what? 85 degrees. That's the target velocity, which is 5 meters per second, and that's the velocity that's measuring now, which is 5 meters per second. And this is sensor reading volts, which the user doesn't really need it, just for information and diagnostic purposes for future. It says 2.2 volts, or 3.2 volts. And we also have the target temperature, 85 degrees C. And then instantaneous temperature is the same as 85 degrees C. And elapsed time is 22 minutes past. Before 60 minutes, so far 22 minutes past. So within 20 minutes, we reached really 85 degrees C at high flow at 5 meters per second.